The Martin-Baker MB.5, a pioneering aircraft of its time, stands as a testament to innovation and ambition. Was this a great invention or a fool's errand? Join me as we delve into the fascinating story of the MB-5, where triumph and tribulation intertwine in the world of aviation engineering. The story of MB-5 starts with the MB-3. When a replacement for the Hurricane and Spitfire was ordered, the birth of MB-3 took place. This required an aircraft with many specifications, like a high-speed single-seat fighter. And with the war coming, one that was capable of operating in any part of the world, regardless of climate, top speed, and many more. In September 1942, a Martin-Baker MB-3 fighter aircraft went down in flames, and the Napier Sabre engine it was powered by failed. Sadly, the pilot and co-founder Baker died in the aircraft. Martin was deeply affected by his friend's death, but he was determined to complete the project. After making numerous altercations on MB-3 plans, the MB-5 came to light. Martin-Baker MB-5 was officially designed to the same Air Ministry specification as the MP-3. Its structure and construction were similar to MB-3, but had changes. MP-5 was made with lightweight materials like aluminium to manage the weight of the aircraft while maintaining structural integrity. The MB-5 was powered by a Rolls-Royce Griffin 83 engine, a high-performance V12 liquid-cooled engine. The engine's power output and design contributed to the aircraft's speed and climb rate. The wing consists of 420mm Hispano MKV cannons, providing the aircraft with its firepower for combat missions. The MB-5 had a conventional low-wing monoplane design. The fuselage of the MB-5 was sleek and streamlined, optimized for reduced drag and increased speed. The Griffin 83 was installed, producing upwards of 2,300 GP and driving two contra-rotating three-bladed propellers. With all the altercations, MB-5 turned out to be heavier and rumored to be similar to the larger single-engine fighters fielded by the Americans. Finally, the construction started in 1983. With World War II going on and Martin's being a perfectionist and dissatisfaction with the many prototypes they built, the project was delayed. Finally, the desired prototype was made in 1944. Another pilot had to be brought in for testing, as Martin was the only pilot. Brian Greenstead loaned from Rotol Lutid, a fellow British aviation firm that specialized in propellers. On the 23rd of May 1944, the completed prototype, R2496, would be disassembled and transported to the testing grounds at RAF Harwell. It was reassembled in a day. On flying the aircraft, Greenstead reported was unsatisfied and informed drawbacks of MB-5. The tides were turned when Martin again modified it according to Greenstead's analysis. This modification took almost 6 months to complete, owing to testing varying rudder sizes. But when Greenstead flew the MB-5 again, the handling had improved dramatically. In terms of performance, the aircraft was highly praised. Martin's dream took flight. Even with all the futuristic modifications and prototypes, the Air Ministry informed Martin that they would not be pursuing further development or placing any production orders for the aircraft. The project was put on ice. This was due to the war coming to an end and the less demand for fighter aircraft. Only one MB-5 prototype was built. This prototype took its first flight in 1944, but it did not enter mass production. Even though the aircraft had only 40 hours of flight time, it was praised by all its pilots. Captain Eric Brown, a pilot famous for his wartime service and as a test pilot, stated after flying the MB-5, "In my opinion, this is an outstanding aircraft, particularly when regarded in the light of the fact that it made its maiden flight as early as the 23rd of May, 1944. MB-5 had been used for testing and was transported from places and was used as a ground target in training exercises. Martin-Baker 5 stood the test of time. Even after the World War, it was flown and praised by countless talented pilots who went on about its futuristic technology added to it. It is proof that it was not a failure. Until its finals days, 1963, it was used and tested. What was left of it was then burned, a tragic end to an amazing creation,